Won't you come and sit with me, sit with me, sit with me? Won't you come and sit with me right here on your rug? Everybody sit with me, yes, sit with me. Everybody sit with me right here on the rug and give yourself a hug. Woo! And curl up like a bug. Yeah! Drink hot chocolate with marshmallows and whipped cream from a mug. Delish. Hi. Hi, everybody. How crazy is this? You're at your house on your rug or chair or couch. I'm at my house. I'm actually in my bedroom. We're not together, but we kind of are. We're kind of Cherry Preschool in a sort of strange sort of way, I know. I'm Julie, and I am a teacher in the Purple Room. Some of you know me because we spend every day together. Some of you know me from when we go to the park. Some of you know me when you see me walking through the halls. All of you have a special place that you go to Cherry Preschool. Some of you go to the Rose Room, and you spend your time with Raina. Some of you also go to the Rose Room on a different day, and you spend your time with Jackie and Annie. And even more of you go to the Rose Room. It's a busy place, that Rose Room. And you spend your time with Linda. And Linda spends lots of time in all the classrooms because she's our music lady. Giddy up. Some of you have a very special place that you call your room, the green room. And there we've got Rachel and Del and Magda and Leah. Then we've also got another special place, the orange room. And that's where you learn all kinds of things from Anne and Michelle and Raina and Linda and Maria. And upstairs, wow, it's the yellow room team. Look at that. It's Mary and Eva and Magda and Angie. We got the red room. Can't forget the red room. We've got Joanne and Thea and Beth. They're all missing you, I will tell you that much. Then we've got the purple room. Look at all those people in the purple room. We've got Sarah and Julie and Maria and Sunita and Lauren. And did you know that in the afternoon there's a different group of people that gather with kids? There's Bea and Raina. That Raina, she's all over the place. And Martha. In the back of the building, we've got the blue room. And there we have these special teachers, Kim and Kitty and Karen and Linda. Those are all the teachers. But then there's a whole nother group of people that help make everything happen there. Our food gets ordered, the bills get paid, the planning gets done, and we call them the office chicks. And lots of times you see them when you come in. They'll be in the door waving at that office door. And we've got Maggie and Lynn and Jenny and Tony and Charlene. And these guys are so special to all of us and also to all of you because they really make it possible for us to do our job. And then, of course, there's Debbie, who brings so much order to our school. She leads us, she directs us, and she also sings to us, right? And she brings those monkeys into our room, and we love those monkeys. So we really are kind of like all Cherry Preschool. I brought them all to show you because I have talked with all of them, and they all miss every single one of you. They really, really do. So with that being said, I think maybe we should just kind of figure out what day it is because it's been a long time since we saw you, right? So in everyone's classroom, or most of them, or maybe not all of them, we kind of try to figure out what day of the week it is. And I am confused because I haven't been to school. So I know that there are songs that some of us sing about the days of the week. Some of us sing Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. That's what we sing in the Purple Room. Some of the classes sing, there's Sunday, then there's Monday, there's Tuesday, then there's Wednesday, there's Thursday, then there's Friday, and then there's Saturday. Ba-da-da-dum, ba-da-da-dum. So whichever way you sing it, you guys do it the way that you want to do it. I'm going to do it the way that we do it in the Purple Room. But there's no right or wrong way. As long as we can figure out what day it is, right? Why, heck. It is the month of March, and we're still in winter. Can you believe it? It is still winter. I wonder when we're going to have spring. I just wonder. So behind me, I have the calendar that we use in the Purple Room. It's different from other kids' calendars, but this is what we use. And I thought that I would just kind of figure out how to use this. It is the month of March. It's a big word. March begins with an M, March. And we've had a lot of days of March so far. This is the number 17. Would you like to count with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. You're right. 18. 18 is next. But also when I look at this, I see colors. I see purple and I see pink. And I see a pattern. Do you see the pattern? Do you see how it goes? Let's see. Purple, pink, purple, pink, purple, pink, a purple, pink, and 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 a purple, pink. Here's the number 18, and it's on a pink card, and it continues the pattern. Oops, I dropped my tape. I'm going to put this right here. And I'm going to tell you, today is Wednesday, March 18th, 2020. Giddy up. Let's go. Put your hands on your head, on your head. Put your hands on your head, on your head. Put your hands on your head. I didn't say it was time to go to bed. Put your hands on your head, on your head. Put your hands on your shoulders, on your shoulders. Put your hands on your shoulders, on your shoulders. Put your hands on your shoulders. You're so strong, you could hold a boulder, which is a big rock. Put your hands on your shoulders, on your shoulders. Put your hands on your knees, on your knees. Put your hands on your knees, on your knees. Put your hands on your knees, and please cover your sneeze. Put your hands on your knees, on your knees. Put your hands on your toes, on your toes. Put your hands on your toes, on your toes. Put your hands on your toes. And please don't pick your nose because it's gross. Put your hands on your toes, on your toes. Put your hands on your belly, on your belly. Put your hands on your belly, on your belly. Put your hands on your belly. And I didn't sing it right because my kids were going to do it over again. Put your hands on your tummy, on your tummy. Put your hands on your tummy, on your tummy. Put your hands on your tummy. And no, you're not a mummy. Put your hands on your tummy, on your tummy. Phew. Sorry about that. I messed up. I'm going to make a lot of mistakes because can I tell you a secret? This is really important. Listen really carefully. I've never made a movie before. And this is kind of like a movie. I've never done it before. I don't really know what I'm doing. I don't know how to push the right buttons. This is the fourth time that I've made this movie. So, are there going to be mistakes? Yeah. Number one, it's okay, because we all make mistakes, every single one of us. And number two, just laugh, because that's all you can do when you make a mistake. It's like, well, I'll try to do it better next time. So hang in there. I'm going to learn, and I'm going to get better. I promise. But right now, I want you to follow the leader. Can you do that with me? Come on now, play follow the leader. Can you do exactly like me? Put your arms way up tall. Let me look at you all. And now you look exactly like me. Come on now, play follow the leader. Can you do exactly like me? Put your hands way out wide. You have one on each side. And now you look exactly like me. Put your hands on your eyes. It's not hard if you try. Put your hands on your nose. You have each one of those. Put your hands on your ears. That's what helps us all hear. And now you look exactly like me. So come on now, play follow the leader. Can you do exactly like me? Please sit down on the floor. That's all there is no more. And now you look exactly like me. Whew! Deep breath. Deep breath, right? I want to read you this book. Just a little story now that we're sitting down and we're kind of taking a chill moment. It's a book that I think a lot of you like. And it's called The Bear Snores On. And I just have to make a little bit of adjustment because, again, remember, I've never done this before. So I'm going to pull this up a little bit so you can see it better. Okay, how's that? Is that pretty good? Here we go. See if I can make it better. Not so much. Okay. Here we go. So, Bear Snores On. What do you think the book is about? Think it's about a bear? I think so. And the book has an author. Do you know what an author is? Author is the person who writes the book. Look at the end papers. These are called end papers. How beautiful is that? It looks like it's kind of wintry, if you ask me. Got snow. Oh. And it tells us on this page that the author of the story is Karma Wilson. And the illustrator, do you know what an illustrator is? That's right. It's the person who writes, who draws the pictures. So an author writes the story, and the illustrator draws the pictures. She's the artist. So the author is Karma Wilson, and the illustrator is Jane Chapman. In a cave in the woods, in his deep, dark lair, through the long, cold winter, sleeps a great brown bear. Cuddled in a heap, with his eyes shut tight, he sleeps through the day, and he sleeps through the night. The cold winds howl, and the night sounds growl. But the bear snores on. An itty-bitty mouse, pitter-patter tiptoe, creep-crawls in the cave from the fluff-cold snow. Mouse squeaks, too damp, too dank. So he lights wee twigs with a small hot spark. The coals pip up and the wind doesn't stop. But the bear snores on. Two glowing eyes sneak peek in the den. Mouse cries, "Who's there?" And a hare hops in. "Ho, mouse," says hare, "long time no see." So they pop white corn and they brew black tea. Mouse sips wee slurps. Hare burps big burps. But the bear snores on. A badger scuttles by, sniffs snuffs at the air. "I smell yummy yums. Perhaps we can share." "I've brought honey nuts," badger says with a grin. "Let's divvy them up, cozy down, and let's dig in." And now they nibble and munch with a chew, a chomp, and a crunch. But the bear snores on. A gopher and a mole tunnel up through the floor. Then a wren and a raven flutter through the door. Mole mutters, "What a night! And what a storm!" twitters wren, and everybody clutters in the great bear's den. They tweet and they twitter. They chat and they chitter. But the bear snores on. In a cave in the woods, a slumbering bear sleeps through the party in his very own lair. Hare stokes the fire, mouse seasons the stew, then a small pepper fleck makes the bear He blows and he sneezes and the whole crowd freezes. And the bear wakes up. Bear gnarls and he snarls. And bear roars and he rumbles. Bear jumps and he stomps. Bear growls and he grumbles. "You've snuck in my lair and you've all had fun. But me, I was sleeping and I have had none." And he whimpers and he moans. And he groans, and the bear blubbers on. Mouse squeaks, "Don't fret, don't fuss. Look, see, we can pop more corn, and we can brew more tea." Bear gulps, he gobbles, and he sighs with delight. Then he spins tall tales through the blustery night. When the sun peeks up on a crisp, clear dawn, bear can't sleep. But his friends snore on. The end. Cool. I like that. I really, really, really like that. I have another book. Before we go, and this book is really fun. I think you're going to like it a lot. Let me see if I can adjust this a little. I'll leave it alone. "You Gotta Go, Buffalo." So, hey, guess what? It says see you later. It means that we're almost to a close, but I want to tell you that you're all going to be hearing from a lot of people from Cherry Preschool. We miss you. We wish you were with you, but we're going to figure this out all together, and be patient with us because we're going to do our very best to let you know how much we love you. So I'm going to say to you, see you later, alligator. I'll see you soon, big baboon. I gotta go. Buffalo. Toodaloo. Kangaroo. Hit the road. Yellow toad. Ciao now. Brown cow. Can't stay. Blue jay. Wave goodbye. Butterfly. When we part, you're in my heart. Bye for now, but not for long. Be well.